So it's a little bit of a mess out here, but I've been making some of the components for the CNC element of the y-axis and doing a lot of video editing, over a week's worth of video editing, just to get the information on the screen that I wanted, because I get a lot of comments on the comment section that I want to answer. So hopefully in the next video I can put the motor on and test the y-axis with the rotary encoder to see how accurate I can get this on the y-axis. Then once I've got the y-axis done, I start to machine out some of the parts for the x-axis using the y-axis CNC, like a one-axis CNC, if that's worth it. We shall see. So in this video, I'm going to put the CAD element here, the steps that I'm taking along the side here, and the tools I'm currently cutting with along here. I hope you enjoy the video.
So there's the first part. The belt needs a little bit of tightening, so I'm going to put another pulley here, just an idler pulley, just to tighten that up, and possibly put a couple of screws in from the top so I can adjust that idler in and out so I can take away any slack on that. So there's plenty of adjustment there. So I've lost the key for the keyway, typical. Can't find it anywhere, but that would sit in like that. So another bearing on this side. Washer and bearing on that side. It's nice and flush there. Washer. Stick that on there. I'll actually assemble this from the other side, so this will go on first. So you can see how it's building up already. So there's a reduction of 2-to-1 there, and then there'll be a reduction of 2-to-1 here as well. So if I put that down there, you've got that belt coming off of there to that pulley. That'll be coming off the front of this motor. On the back of the motor, you'll have this rotary encoder, so I can read the accurate position there, and that will sit on the front like that. And then that will drive the y-axis backwards and forwards. On just a thought, I had the motor the wrong way around. It's this way around. So the wires have come out the bottom. The rotary encoder goes on the back. That's the back, because that's where the bearing is. So that would sit on there and tie in with the flat on the drive shaft. Stay. Something like that.
If you've liked this video, please hit the thumbs up and the subscribe button as well. And please leave your comments in the comment section and I'll try and get back to you. And thank you very much for watching.